Hi friends, in this video we explain the basic knowledge required for making external memory interfacing with 8051. Pins involved in external memory interfacing are port 0, port 2, ALE, EA and PSEN. Now let us recall 8051's pin diagram. Already we discussed port 1, port 3, port 0 and port 2. Here for external memory interfacing we need to know something, that is port 0. The port 0 can act as a input or output line, or otherwise it acts as an address line, address or data line of lower byte. Similarly, port 2, port 2 2.0 to 2.7 act as a either port 2 2.0 to 2.7 act as a address line, higher byte address line, AA to A15. So totally the 8051 supports 16 bit address lines, that is 16 bit. So AD0 to AD7 and AA to A15, totally 16 address lines it supports. So these address lines are obtained from port 0 and port 2. So remaining 3 pins are required for external memory interfacing. One of them is EA bar, ALE, PSEN. So EA is nothing but external access, ALE is nothing but address latch enable, program store enable, PSEN is nothing but program store enable. These 3 pins imparts a main role in external memory interfacing. Okay. Now we come to this point. Port 0 either acts as the IO pins, otherwise it acts as a lower byte address lines. Similarly, port 0, port 2 acts as either input or output lines, otherwise it acts as a higher byte address lines. Here we discuss the memory system of 8051 microcontroller. Generally, 8051 microcontroller uses separate memories for program storage and data storage. So here written is separate memories 8051 handles. One of them is program memory, second one is data memory. So program memory contains only the program, and data memory contains the data required for manipulations like variables, constants or intermediate results can be stored in the data memory. Let us discuss first program memory. So the program memory can be type of ROM or EEPROM or EEPROM or flash memory. So here only we store the program. So it is nothing but only program storage. So read only happens. We do not write anything in the program memory. Here we can classify the program memory into two. One is internal memory, second is external memory. Here in this IC contents internal program memory of size 4 KB. So here this program memory is available inside the chip, hence this memory is called on chip program memory. Similarly, when we talk about the data memory, so what type of memories are used is static RAM or dynamic RAM. Otherwise, sometimes the data can be held in the read-only memory. So it is nothing but fixed data. We cannot write the data. We just only read the required data. That is called read-only. So here we use this type of memory only for data storage. So here we can read or write the RAM memory. Here also the 8051 microcontroller will have internal data memory of 128 bytes. So this memory is available inside the chip. Hence this type of memory is called on-chip data memory. So what are the connections we have to make to use these internal memories? First one, EA pin. So the EA pin is the 31st pin of the microcontroller. That should be tied with supply voltage plus VCC, that is 5 volt, and as well as PSEN bar. That pin is not considered here for connecting the internal program memory. So the address ranges, so totally 4 KBs are there. The starting address of the memory is 0000H. The final end of the location is 0FFFH. So here these locations are pointed by the register called program counter. In data memory, so the data memory is having only 8 bit addresses, so starts from 00 to 7FH, totally 128 bytes. So here the program counter is not used, we can directly address these memories. We discuss only the program memory. So how much memory is required? First we have to fix. If I am writing a program, that program size may be within the range of 4 KB, or otherwise it can go exceed the 4 KB size. Hence we have to choose accordingly. First of all, the requirement of program memory depends on the program size. So how much the capacity of program we have to decide. So the program size, we have two cases. If the program size is less than or equal to 4 KB, we directly use the internal memory. So internal memory is sufficient, no external memory is required. Similarly, when the program size goes beyond the 4 KB size, we have to choose the external memory or internal memory. Sorry, we have to choose the external memory. Okay, first of all, we see internal memory. So when the program size is lesser than or equal to 4 KB, internal memory is sufficient, no external memory is required. So at that time, what we have to do, we have to make the EA pin as 1 and PSEN bar should be not connected, that means left open. So this is the 8051 microcontroller. Inside we have 4 KB ROM chip. So to utilize this memory for program, we have to make the EA pin should be connected to VCC. That means here we have mentioned EA is equal to 1. So we have to connect this EA pin to the supply voltage, then it refers to the memory locations from the internal program memory. Otherwise, when we talk about the program size that exceeds the 4 KB, there are two options. The first option is either we can use internal memory 4 KB along with the external memory remaining 60 KB, because we have 2 power 16 combinations. So we get 65,536 bytes. So that can be written as 64 kilobytes. So total addressing space is 64 kilobytes. Here in internal memory, I can utilize 4. If the memory is not sufficient, I can take remaining portions from the external memory. So remaining, I have 60 KB space. I can utilize, for example, my program size comes under 6 KB means I can use internal memory of 4 KB plus 2 KB from the external. At that time, what I have to do, I have to make EA is equal to 1 and the PS EN bar is equal to 0. So in the internal memory selection, we done EA is equal to 1 similar to this. But PS EN is left open because it says that you can take the program from the external memory. So here we don't use the external memory, hence we left open. But here up to 4 KB, we are utilizing the internal memory. The remaining portions we are taking here, when we move from internal memory to external memory, we have to make the PS EN pin to 0. So we have to connect the PS EN to 0, EA pin to positive supply. Okay, so from the beginning, it refers to the internal memory. The program counter increments each time. When it goes to the maximum limit of the internal program memory, it next shifts to the base of the 60 KB memory, it goes on. Okay. The second option in external memory interfacing is, I don't want to use the internal memory entirely. I can completely use the external memory instead of internal and external. Hence, we have to make two things. EA pin should be kept as 0, that is grounded. PS EN bar is also grounded because the program is kept inside the external program memory. Okay, so for that we have to make two options. First one, PS EN bar should be made as 0. Similarly, EA pin also should be made 0. So EA pin says that I am not using the internal memory for program. We just use the external memory for program. The PS EN bar says when it is grounded, the entire program is available in the external memory. So here there is no role of internal memory, only external memory is used. Need for external memory interfacing in 8051 microcontroller. 8051 microcontrollers have a limited amount of on-chip ROM. In many systems where the on-chip ROM of the 8051 is not sufficient at that time, the external memory is needed to accommodate the code or data, because external memory allows us to write program with the size as large as 64 kilobytes. In 8051, generally it contains on-chip ROM of nearly 4 KB or 8 KB ROM. Hence, if the memory is not sufficient, we need an external memory. But the external memory supports up to 64 kilobytes of storage. So that is the main need for external memory interfacing in 8051 microcontroller. Next, we see what is the role of the 8051's pin. 8051 microcontroller's pin have some role for external memory interfacing, especially program ROM. These are the five types of pins that plays a vital role in external memory interfacing of program ROM. First one, EA pin. So EA pin, we can say EA bar. EA bar pin, port 0, port 2, PS EN bar pin, ALE pin. So let me discuss one by one. Here we discuss the role of EA bar pin. This pin have two configurations. This pin should be connected to VCC to indicate that program code is stored in microcontroller's on-chip ROM. Means the program written is stored in the internal ROM memory. At that time, we have to connect this pin to VCC. The second option, this pin should be connected to ground to indicate that the program code is stored in external ROM. So if the internal ROM is not sufficient, we opt the external ROM. At that time, EA bar pin should be connected to 0. So here it is indicated EA bar is equal to 0. That means connected to ground for external ROM interfacing. Here we discuss the role of port 0, port 2 and ALE pin. Port 0 and port 2 provides the 16-bit addresses to access external memory. Either the memory may be program memory or data memory. Okay, whatever the type of memory, whatever the things we store in the memory, these two ports are used to provide the 16-bit addresses. Why it provides 16-bit address? Because program counter is 16-bit. Now we see port 0 provides the lower 8-bit address A0 to A7 and 8-bit data D0 to D7. Generally port 2 will have the structure of multiplexed address and data bus. Second, port 2 provides the upper 8-bit address A8 to A15. As I said earlier, P0, the port 0 is a multiplexed pins that provide address as well as data. This is mainly done for saving the I/O pins. But we need address lines and data lines should be separated. For this, we use latches. We use latches to demultiplex the port 0 to have the separate address lines and data lines. So for this, ALE pin is used for the latch. Next we see what is the role of ALE pin. ALE is the output pin of microcontroller. When ALE is made as 0, 8051 uses port 0 for data path. Means the port 0 act as a data lines. Hence the data transfer takes place between controller and the memory. When we want to send the address to point to the memory location, we have to make ALE as 1. Hence 8051 uses port 0 for address path A0 to A7. So using this pin only, we are demultiplexing the address and data lines of port 0. So this is the structure of the latch. The latch is having 8 input pins and 8 output pins. Inside we have 2 components. One is D latch, that is D flip flop. Another one is inverter logic. Each pin will have individual D flip flop and inverter. Okay. So here I have shown for only one pin. Like that we have to connect this input pins to the port 0's output pin. Similarly, the output of this latch is taken, that is connected to the memory IC. Here you see this is the enable pin. This pin should be connected to ALE pin of the microcontroller. Okay. So this is the output control pin. Whenever you want to feed the input to the output, we have to make this pin to the ground. So here the truth table is written. So the enable pin, we have G is the enable pin. The enable pin is denoted as G. So whenever G is high, then only the input is forwarded to the output. Low to low, high to high. If the input is high, the output will be high when the enable pin is high. Similarly, when the input is low, the output is also low when the enable pin is high. So during this time, the output control pin should be made as ground. Here we see how to connect the latch to port 0 and ALE pin is shown here. First of all, we see the description. To extract the addresses from port 0 pins, a latch 78LS373, it is an 8-bit latch. A latch can be connected and ALE pin can be used to latch the address as in the following figure. So this extracting of the addresses from P0 is called address or data multiplexing. Address and data, demultiplexing, you have to write demultiplexing. So here we see the diagram. So it is a 8051. The output is fed to the latch input. So the input contains each D flip flop. The output side we have the inverter. So when we pass the address through this line, at that time we have to make ALE pin as 1. So that all the D flip flops are enabled and it moves the data to the inverter. So the here inversion operation happens. So when the output control is always grounded to 0. So it should be connected to ground so that all the inverters are enabled. The output is available here. When we pass the address, it happens here. When they pass the data in the similar lines, at that time the ALE made as the 0. Hence all the units inside the IC is off. Hence, all the data values are passed through the data lines D0 to D7. So this is the working principle of the port 0 and ALE pin using the latch IC. The role of PSEN bar, role of PSEN bar. So the name of the pin is program store enable. This is mainly used when your program is available in the external memory. To fetch the instructions or program from the memory, we have to enable this pin, program store enable, by making this pin as equal to 0 or equal to grounded. We have to do this for fetching the instructions from the memory. It is an output signal for 8051 microcontroller. This must be connected to OE pin, not OE pin, OE bar pin. So the OE bar pin is available in the memory chip. So that PSEN bar should be connected to OE bar pin to fetch any instructions from the memory. To access external ROM containing program code, 8051 uses this signal PSEN bar. If the program or code contained in external ROM, then EA bar and PSEN bar should be made 0. Otherwise, if the program or code contained in internal ROM, that is on-chip ROM, EA bar is made as 1 and PSEN bar should be not connected, that means not activated by microcontroller. As for now, we have discussed the role of EA bar pin, PSEN bar pin, port 0, port 2 and ALE pin. Here we see, sometimes we use both the on-chip ROM as well as off-chip ROM, where it should be used. We have to discuss here. Generally, the on-chip ROM can be used for storing boot code. So, usually in my computers, there will be motherboard. In that motherboard, we have some on-chip ROM. That ROM will store the boot code called BIOS code. Off-chip ROM can be used for storing user's program. So, off-chip ROM contains the program written by the users. So, that type of ROM can be replaced with non-volatile RAM. So, we know the characteristics of RAM is nothing but volatile. When the power is switched off, the contents will be erased. But when we use this memory for holding the user's program, that should not be erased frequently. Hence, it should be preserved. For that, we use the facility non-volatile of read random access memory. In that type of system, still we have EA bar is equal to 1. Means when system is reset, 8051 executes the on-chip program first, means it has to boot the system first, then when it reaches the end of the on-chip ROM, so it starts from 000 to 0FFF, then it switches to the off-chip ROM from the location 1000 to FFFF. So this happens here when both the chips are used, on-chip as well as off-chip. Okay. When there is no need of on-chip and off-chip ROM, we directly use the off-chip ROM entire for 64 kilobytes by making EA bar pin is equal to 0. Here also we use EA bar is equal to 1.